Good morning again and welcome to the Today Show Kitchen. We are here because it is hard to imagine, impossible to imagine Anzac Day without the golden syrupy Anzac biscuits.
And here to show us how it's done, we're joined by Chef Courtney Ralston. Thank you for coming in, Courtney.
Thank Thanks for having me. Such a special day to be in here.
You're getting started. You've already got things going.
We've got things going. And look, Anzac biscuits are a very simple recipe. Mm. We've got 150 grams of butter and about 2 tablespoons of golden syrup in our pan here heating up.
Okay.
We're going to go in with about 1/2 teaspoon of bicarb. And this is the, you know, if kids are making this today at home, this is the fun part of the recipe. The bicarb will puff up.
Okay.
So just like you're making honeycomb.
Just gives it a bit more volume and stuff.
It gives the biscuits a bit of lightness. So that's a bit of fun thing for the kids to do. Richard, we're going to put you to work.
Oh, heavens.
So the other ingredients for traditional Anzac biscuits, 1 1/4 cups of oats, mm-hmm. 1 1/4 cups of plain flour, 3/4 cup of desiccated coconut, 1/2 cup of brown sugar. Very simple. Okay. Most people would have this stuff at home, probably in their pantry, I would
My
say.
My job to lick the bowl.
Not that one, it's hot.
That one is hot. Yeah, you'll lose all the skin off your mouth, I think, if you do that one. And then it's really simple. Then you just mix it up and then you can roll them about a tablespoon kind of size pieces. Again, good one for the kids.
Yeah.
So crunchy or soft?
Well, that's...
They've got to be soft, chewy. Right.
Well, some people like them hard as a rock, don't they?
Yeah.
I like them a little bit bendy, I think. What's this particular variety?
These ones are soft.
Right.
So if people are at home and they want crunchy ones, and traditionally these always were crunchy. These were, you know, these were designed to send on ships over to our soldiers. Mm. So replace the brown sugar with white sugar.
Yeah.
And cook them at a higher temperature. So these ones I've cooked at 160 degrees for around 12 to 14 minutes. Mm. So if you want crunchy, pop in white sugar and cook them at about 180, 190, and they will go crispy. Just watch the dentures. You know, if you've got fragile teeth, I recommend this recipe.
I'm also intrigued by what you've got over here, which is like an Anzac
slab of the stuff.
Yeah.
Cake?
Yeah.
So then, Richard, then all we do, clean hands, and you just roll them into balls and they can go into here.
Yeah, okay.
Jane, this is for... Look, we don't want to mess with the Anzac biscuit recipe, but this is for... This is like the yumminess
of...
Perfect, yes.
Perfect.
Big boulders.
Not a word I hear of.
This is the same recipe. I've added in some sunflower seeds. So this is a good one. I know kids are back at school now as well. But it's just for lazy cooks that don't want to get messy and roll them into this. You just basically the same ingredients.
Okay.
Pop them into a slice tray. Press it down with a spoon, and this goes in the oven for 20 minutes, and then all you need to do is to slice them up.
Okay, I'm going to have a taste of that. While I do that, can you give us a bit of a history on the Anzac? I'll take the small one.
Yeah.
Well, I think Anzac biscuits are, and this is why I haven't changed the biscuit recipe, it's really sacred. I think it was for mums and wives that were concerned about the nutritional food that our soldiers were getting. Over in World War One, I think, you know, back in school, I think I remember stories about bully beef in tins and this was from concerned mums, wives, sisters back in Australia. They would bake the Anzac biscuits. They were called soldier biscuits or soldier tiles back in the day.
Okay.
Yeah. So they would bake them always crispy because, you know, these were made to send on ships in sealed tins. And these would get sent over to our soldiers and it was a little unique taste of Australia that would, you know, end up with our soldiers. It's a lovely story and it's a great thing to do today. Yeah.
And hence the tradition began.
Yeah. Yes. And it's great that, you know, it's not Anzac Day without an Anzac biscuit.
No, that's very true. Hey, thank you, Chef Courtney. We appreciate you coming in.
Thank you. Richard's made boulders. This is great.
Right. Yeah.